Hey everyone, Scorch82, welcome back to another episode of Off the Shelf. This time around, it's Final Fantasy III or Final Fantasy VI for the Super Nintendo Entertainment System. This is one of my favorite games of all time, and I'm really looking forward to getting back into the Super NES and starting with a really good RPG from 1995 by Squaresoft. And I don't know about some of you, but I will always remember this as Final Fantasy III, like the actual Final Fantasy III, even though I know it's not, 94. Even though it's not really Final Fantasy III, everyone knows it's VI. The version I grew up with, and the one I know, is the one that I'll always remember is this one. So, let's jump right in here. Intro sequence. Long ago, the War of the Magi reduced the world to a scorched wasteland, and magic simply ceased to exist. I don't know how much voiceover acting I'm going to be doing, but we'll see. 1,000 years have passed, iron, gunpowder, and steam engines have been rediscovered, and high technology reigns. But there are some who would enslave the world by reviving the dread destructive force known as magic. Can it be that those in power are on the verge of repeating a senseless and deadly mistake? This is one of the first images I remember of this game, too. There's the town. Hard to believe an Esper's been found intact there 1,000 years after the War of the Magi. Think it's still alive? Probably, judging from the urgency of our orders. And this woman, this sorcerer, why is she here? I heard she fried 50 of our Magitek armored soldiers in under 3 minutes. Not to worry, the slave crown on her head robs her of all conscious thought. She'll follow orders. We'll approach from the east. Move out! So, this is going to be one of those games where there's probably going to be a lot of character names and things that I'm going to pronounce a certain way and somebody's going to say that's not it. Like I said, I grew up with this, so I remember it. I'll pronounce them the way I pronounce them in whatever. Thank you. Back when games had really good intro sequences. Or memorable intro sequences. Not to say that some now don't, but anyway. We're at the mountain town of Narshe. Let's put her on point. No sense taking any risks. Forward! So I'm going to preface by saying that I'm not going to be utilizing save states, even though I'm on an emulator. This game is one that I know fairly well, and I'm probably going to do my best to just use regular old save points. I'll probably be save stating just to track progress in case like a recording messes up or something like that. Or in order to cut apart when convenient, but for the most part I'll be playing as if I'm on the actual console, so hope you enjoy. Let's make our way through the town. Imperial Magitek armor, not even Narshe is safe anymore. First battle. This is always a cool scene because you get to use the Magitek armor. My favorite was always used to use the fire beam on everybody. And Terra was always cool because she got to have all the extra Magitek powers. But I spoiled it because she's not named yet. Yeah. This is the actual Super Nintendo version where they use GP instead of Gil. Narshe's freedom depends on us! Send in the Lobos! Los Lobos! Important thing is to make use of the heal beam, the heal force, whenever possible. I'm gonna have to change my options because I don't like the memory cursor. We don't get much for killing them, do we? Guard. Some of the best music here. This game has it all. I remember I put, pretty much well into 90 hours on a save file I had on my Super Nintendo. The actual cartridge. Let's see. Battle mode is between active and wait. Active means that while you're in menus, enemies can still attack you. I think the speed is good for now. The gauge just shows the battle gauge when you're ready to attack, which I like to leave on. Cursor, I always go... Looks like it was already on reset, but that basically means that that the cursor position returns to wherever it was at the beginning of the menu as opposed to wherever you had it last. Re-equip optimum or empty. This is whenever you change equipment or something that causes your equipment to change, that it equips you with the optimum stuff. This was a really nice option. This is one of the first RPGs that allowed you to actually use multiple controllers. Secret of Mana was another one that let you do that. Came out before this. This basically allowed you to have another player controlling. I think it's either certain characters or certain menus or whatever the deal is. I don't really remember what the... I think this is how you assigned it. You click on it and then you can change which characters or which controller, which kind of lets your friends have some fun in there. This is for ordering of your magic. I like magic order number one. It's basically the different permutations of your spells. Healing first, then attack, and then effect. Always nice. And here's the different windows that you can use. My favorite one was always this one. It looked kind of like water or lightning or whatever it is. And you could change the window color as well. I always like white font. Just to stick with it. Let's go! We've got him trapped now! Oh shit. It's a pincer attack. Hey man, ease up man. Let's kill one, and then heal force. Gotta keep your energy up. So I imagine that through the course of this game, it's going to get really boring. Doing all the random battles and grinding for HP and all or XP and all that stuff. So I'm going to off-screen a lot of that stuff where I just have to go back and forth and learn stuff. There's a few places throughout the game that I really like to do that kind of stuff. And I'll take note of it. Just so at least you know. But this will probably keep me busy for a while. We must defend the mines! Volmemeth! Ice beam them. I remember seeing these from the commercial. I remember a commercial for this game showing this particular sequence and a few others. Psychedelic, man. Let's see. According to our source, the frozen Esper was found in a new mine shaft. Maybe this one. Let's go. Oh, there's a save point. A were-rat. I think these things are weak against fire. Not that it matters with the fire beam, but you know. Gained a level. Wedge gained a level. These little stars here are the save points. An eerie glow surrounds you. Want info about save points? No, I'm good. Let's go to our menu. And pick an empty spot. So those will be used for doing progress saving and like using tents and cabins and stuff like that. I'll handle this, stand back. Judo chop! We won't hand over the Esper. Welk, get them! Alright, so now we get the boss music. Hold it. Think back to our briefing. What about it? You recall hearing about a monster that eats lightning? Stores the energy in a shell. Alright, so whatever you do, don't attack the shell. Alright, already. Alright, so what I'm gonna do is normally you can use that little exchange there to figure out how to beat this boss, only attacking the head, but if you manage to kill it by using whatever attacks you have on the shell, even though it hurts you, you get an item that's somewhat worth the reward at the end. However, I probably shouldn't have let her die. Yeah, I probably should have, I can't bring her back to life now because I don't have any Phoenix Downs. So what I'm going to have to do is I'm going to reload my save. She barely has enough to survive that. Let's move her to the back row. And then I've got to get enough, it's not really worth it to do it, but I figure just to try. She has magic. Her heal force is better. Let's just use the magic. not gonna hurt nothing, right? Moving her to the back row prevents her from taking damage, but I think magic still does the same, same to you. So save again. Let's give it another shot. Experience can't hurt. Gotta keep her HP up, so in case she takes damage. Give it a shot. If I run into more difficulties, I'll just defeat it regularly. I think all you get is like an ether or something that's Well, see you later. Okay, already. So we're gonna switch to Terra, use Tech Missile, and then Heal Force on whoever it hits. I usually keep one spare dude with an attack. So that way I can heal. She is barely alive. That's ice beam you. Can use cure. It takes a little bit to get anything out of that, but let's see. Ice beam. I'm ready. I'm ready for you. So this is where you. He retreats into his shell. Tech missile. Mega bolt. Question marks attack to come back. This always added kind of a nifty challenge to the mix. Heal yourself. Go Tech Missile. Need MP. See, now he's out of MP, so this just should be easy now. Okay. Pointless. So you get a tincture instead of a potion for doing that. It took about 25 minutes. It's the most useless task for the most... Well, it's not really a useless reward, because tinctures are fairly valuable compared to potions, but you may not want to waste your life doing that. I managed to take advantage of the emulator speed-up in order to do that. Alrighty then. You will have appreciated that I cut most of that out. This is the Frozen Esper. Oh shit. Tritoch. Hey, what's the matter? Do you know something we don't? Frozen creature began emitting an eerie light. Where's that light coming from? Hey, witch, where are you? What's happening? Dot 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 dot. She's exploding. So now we get control of our character again. Where am I? Whoa, I only just removed the crown. Head hurts. Can't stand up. Easy, this is the slave crown. The others had complete control over you while you were wearing it. I can't remember a thing. Don't worry, it's all come back to you. It'll all come back to you in time, that is. No! A mysterious young woman, controlled by the Empire, born with the gift of magic. Terra. So I'm going with the original names, because that's the only way to play a Final Fantasy game. My name is Terra. Impressive, I've never heard of anyone recovering this fast. As quick as I can push the start button. Shh. Open up! Give us back the girl in the Empire's Magitek armor! Open this door, we want that girl. She's an officer of the Empire. Screw you, man. Empire? Magitek armor? Old man, look. I have to get you out of here, and I don't have time to explain. Over here! So I think you can actually steal things from, the clocks in the game have... Open this door, I want that girl! Most of the clocks in this game that you find inside buildings and such will have items in them, and you can take them. Make your way out through the mines, I'll keep these brutes occupied. They're already gone. She's up there! Quick, throw rocks! Let's make our way through the mines. Ooh, save point. Which actually might be a good time for a break. So, when we come back, more Final Fantasy III, and I will see you all later. Thanks for watching.